Activists have stormed into Birkenhead County Court and tried to arrest a judge. The group, who call themselves the People's United Community, say the action was intended to shake the foundations of the establishment. Six demonstrators were arrested.
I'm in control. You're in control. We're in control. They're in control. I'm in control. You're in control. We're in control. They're in control.
Arrest that judge!
2 minutes in a history book is all the information you will ever need to figure out that a few wealthy people own the planet and it's run for their benefit. In fact, you don't even need to read that history book. I could just show you the pictures. Here you go. Here's the pictures from the history book. Here's them locking people up who didn't do what the government said. Well, there's a big problem in the world, and this is what we're gonna do about it. Why don't you join us or shut the fuck up?
And there's courts of justice. How many people in this room suffered at the hands of the courts of justice where injustice is actually happening? Even the highest court in the land is a corporation, the House of Lords. We believe that the courts are issuing us justice. We believe that we're going to get a lawful trial.
That's a very good question. It's all a bit hush-hush at the moment, waiting to see exactly what we've got to do and what these umbrellas are for.
Could you give me the name of your tailor before you go?
Yes. I think you'll find him in Asda. George something is called, I think.
What we've been asked to tell you is, could you possibly please form in groups of, like, 10 or 20, with someone who we can hand some leaflets to.
Hello, Veronica. I don't really need a loud hailer, but I've got one here if you'd like this.
Yeah. What we'd like to do, or what we've been asked you could do, please, is to form in sort of groups of 10 to 20, and then when you hear the whistle, make your way to the county court. That's basically all I can tell you at the moment.
Is that a real ship, is it?
Well, yeah, that was a ship I was on 67 years ago. I don't know whether it'll pick that up or not, will it? I'm on the right there, the middle of those three, the sinking of the German battleship Scharnhorst. So the finest, bravest, most feared battleship of any navy during World War II. And I was there right in the middle of that. I'm not proud of it, I was only a lad, 18 year old at the time, and I played my very small part in killing 1,867 of the bravest men in the world, the crew of the German battle cruiser Scharnhorst. I'm not proud of it. It's a tragedy that all those men, British and German, died in vain.
For a lie.
And the members of Parliament are a company. Gordon Brown is a company. David Cameron is a company. And this one I like. The Labour Party trade as Alistair Darling MP. The reason they trade with Alistair Darling MP is because Alistair Darling is a diplomat. That trading name has diplomatic status. That means they can bend things and do things that you don't know about.
I was proud to be British until the age of 70.
Acts of Parliament become statutes, primary legislation. Internal are enacted, enforced by statutory instruments, which are secondary legislation.
Not the land for which I had fought in World War II.
Council tax is a statutory instrument enacted on the 1st of April 1993 under the primary legislation, the Local Government Finance Act of 1992.
Not the land for which my brave young shipmates had given their lives.
But when we look at a statutory instrument, we find it's a created, written, legal contract.
Got many shocks as I learned that Britain was not the land I had always believed it to be.
This is what politics is about. This is what you believe to be the people representing you. Council tax is a statutory instrument enacted on the 1st of April 1993 under the primary legislation, the Local Government Finance Act of 1992. When we look at a statutory instrument, we find it's a created, written, legal contract. It's not law. Where does it say it's law? Can you see it?
Look up Quisling and you'll see who he was. And there were Quislings waiting in Britain when Hitler failed. But no tyranny was ever overturned without those prepared to give their liberty and their life.
Yes.
It's given the force of law, which means it will apply to you if you consent. What does the word consent mean? Exactly. So what happens when you don't agree? It isn't law.
Ah, the government. It loves you and wants to keep you safe and well. It even wants to make paying taxes, fines, and court costs easier for you. How? Well, you'll need to meet your straw man. He was born the same day you were. He looks like you, has the same name, and lives in your house, but you never knew he existed. You will have even paid his parking tickets or taxes. The worst part? He's been dead from day one.
By its own definition, it only applies to a person and not a man or a woman. How many people in the audience today think they're a person?
From every birth certificate, a legal personality, or legal fiction, is created with the same name to confuse little old you into thinking it's you. So, there is a human you and a paper you, or as it's commonly known, a straw man. So when it seems like government officials, court clerks, or the police are speaking English, they aren't. They're speaking legalese, designed to make you agree to verbal and written contracts without even knowing about it, all spun from Black's Law Dictionary. For example, when the police say, "Do you understand?" you'll say, "Yes." What they are really saying is, "Do you stand under our authority?" Oopsie-daisy, you just created a verbal contract with them. Oh, you clever government.
The United Kingdom is a corporation. Now, up till February of last year, it was United Kingdom PLC. It's dissolved and they've never, ever published their accounts. You want to check that out? Go on Company's House. On Dun & Bradstreet, they're now registered as United Kingdom Corporation Limited. Any corporation has employees. The employees are not just civil servants. They're all of you, every one of you. If you have a national insurance number, that means you too are an employee. Company policy of this corporation requires you as an employee to pay tax, follow all the legislative rules of that corporation, in this case, statutes.
We're doing it for the human race, aren't we? For those that are children now, we have a duty to make sure they've got a better world. I've always wanted a better world, anyway, a human world. Cooperation is far better than confrontation, and that is what we really should be concentrating on. These are t-shirts I make, print myself, my own little designs. I'm doing my bit, spread the message, get us a humane world.
I was there 3 weeks ago when Roger was in the court, and the judge was repeatedly asked, "Are you here, sir, under your oath of office?" And he said, he would not declare whether he was or he wasn't. He prevaricated, he went and wandered off on different subjects. For half an hour, we tried to get him to say whether he was there under his oath of office. The reason being very simple, under common law, if he was there, his oath is there to basically oversee common law, in which case the whole thing would be thrown out because the whole thing is a statute and it's fraudulent and everything else. If he'd said, "No, I'm not here under my oath of office," then he was just like an ordinary person, like any one of us, in which case he had no jurisdiction over anybody in that room. So it's a very simple case. The man has got to say whether he's there under his oath of office. Whichever way, we win.
So what do you propose to do then?
Well, I believe there are some there who are wanting to uphold common law, and if that means arresting somebody, could be the person impersonating a judge, who knows, then so be it. Common law has to prevail today. Common law prevails at all times over statute rules of society. And unfortunately, the friends in uniform and the people who run the court, who are private businesses, they're all corporatized courts. They are the ones who are against common law. They are the ones making sure that common law does not prevail. We, as honest citizens, have to see that common law prevails. So we have to take whatever appropriate action, peaceful action, to make sure that common law prevails.
I am the third party representative for Mr. Roger Hayes.
Are you Mr. Roger Hayes?
No, you may address me as Roger.
I will call you Mr. Hayes.
The court is required to address me as I request.
I will take note that Mr. Roger Hayes is not represented in court.
You will have to also note that the counsel is not represented in court.
I can see that the counsel has representation in the court.
If counsel has representation in court, then so does Mr. Roger Hayes. The counsel is a corporation and so is Mr. Roger Hayes.
Mr. Roger Hayes is not a corporation.
Yes, it is.
It is a person.
A person is a corporation.
No, it is not.
Define person. Then let me do it for you.
When you get a bill, It's sent to you, but belongs to your straw man, not you. That's why bills, fines, and summons start with Mr., Mrs., or Ms. Sometimes you'll see your surname in capitals, just like on a gravestone. That's because your straw man is dead, and just a silly piece of paper, created before you could comprehend or even consent to it. When you go to court, you represent your straw man, so you, the human, take on any costs, fees, taxes, and fines involved for the straw man. The human you doesn't even need to pay them. But you made a contract with the court by appearing on behalf of your legal personality or straw man, just like the government knew you would. Confused?
As in any company, if you break the rules, you will be disciplined under that company's legislation. The police of the United Kingdom Corporation are all companies too, run for profit. Because that's what companies basically do. And who are they making profit for? Directors, shareholders, they all want a profit. And where does that profit come from? The corporate policy enforcement officers, their job is to enforce the rules of the corporation. Courts of the United Kingdom Corporation are all companies run for profit as well. If you break the rules, you will get an invite, a summons to their place of business to discuss your punishment. Even the highest court in the land is a corporation, the House of Lords. We believe that the courts are issuing us justice. We believe that we're going to get a lawful trial. There is a massive difference between lawful and legal. A policeman, a human being, his duty under common law of this land is to serve and protect every individual in this land. They must uphold the common law, but they have a fiction attached to them called a police officer. Now, if you look at the word officer, it comes from the corporate world. What's a CEO? Chief Executive Officer.
People are rebelling lawfully and peacefully. And the key bit that's started this is that we now know that statute, law, or administrative courts are being held. Those courts are unlawful under common law. And so we are seeing people penalised in court for parking fines or council tax fines or any of these other statute law offences, which are actually unlawful. And it's vitally important that we wake the majority of the British people up to the fact that their country is being destroyed and the people destroying it are our own MPs in Parliament. It doesn't matter what party they come from. We know that Cameron, Brown, Blair, Clegg, Miliband and others have committed treason, and the time is coming when the people of this country are going to bring them to book.
Campsite Earth. There are 100 tents. Yeah? And 10 tents at the top of the campsite own you. They own the field, they own the tents, they own the people, and your only purpose is to keep them fat and fucking happy.
All we would stress today and in future is that the way to do it is lawfully and peaceably. But lawful rebellion is our right, because inside this building is a kangaroo court which believes it can extract council tax from a legal fiction.
You are you, alive and made of flesh and blood. Your straw man or legal personality is a piece of paper created from your birth certificate. And you think it's you. What a silly billy.
We're tired of being treated like objects. We are people, we are individuals, and we want our freedoms.
We've got rights, we should be heard. I'm a great-grandmother going to be shortly, and I've got grandchildren, and I want a decent place. I don't want corruption as bad as it is in the higher places that we've got now.
Certain people are missing today. BBC, ITV, the Murdoch Empire. Why do you think
that is? The answer is very simple. We know that the BBC, with Patton in charge, is an absolute propaganda machine, and the rest of the British media and newspapers are controlled by a very small group of people, driven by our corrupt politicians and the fraudulent bankers.
I'm just fed up of government and authorities finding new and inventive ways to take my hard-earned money off me.
Against the education cuts.
Different taxes, different fines.
All the taxes that are going up, any opportunity it is to get more money off you.
Are you some kind of subversive militant pinko Trotskyite lefty?
No, I'm just a great grandmother with a strong sense of duty to most people.
Now you go and speak to an audience, they are absolutely hungry for for you to tell them what's happening. The parties have been infiltrated. We need independent people who are prepared to stand up for their country.
So I want them to grow up into a world that's peaceful, in our own nation, and fair.
There's a lot of forelock tugging going on. We all know our place. We just want a job and a television, a cold beer, and we want our shit to flush away when we press the plunger.
It's absolutely wrong to...